日本語を勉強しましょう With Motoka 先生。みなさんこんにちは。8番のレッスンへようこそ。 Hey, what's up guys and welcome back to lesson 8. Today we're talking all about mass verbs. Now this one's really important, so I highly suggest that you watch the whole thing if you can. We're gonna go through conjugations. I'm gonna share a few of the very important verbs that you need to know, and then probably in the next video or a future video, I'm gonna go through more verbs that are used in daily conversation. Now just a quick explanation about mass verbs. Mass verbs are classified basically by the end of the verb. It ends with mass. This is more of a formal way of speaking. So if you're watching anime all the time, you might not hear mass verbs as much as you do futsuke, which is more plain style, dictionary form, a lot more informal and used more with friends or colleagues instead of people who you are not as familiar with. But whenever you're introducing yourself, speaking to people you don't really know, speaking to people who have a higher status as you, or maybe older people as well, you always want to use mass form. And it never hurts to just use it all the time too, especially if you don't know futsuke. So that's why usually in Japanese school, I believe you learn mass form before you learn futsuke. You might learn the dictionary form of the verb first, but because you're probably going to use the mass form a little more, we're just going to learn the mass form first, and then in later videos we can always go over futsuke and dictionary form and get more used to that. So let's get started. So the conjugation for mass verbs: mas, masen, mashita, masen deshita. And if you think this sounds a little familiar, I would highly recommend going back to the this video where I talk all about this. This is also a verb as well, and it has similar conjugations, I would say. Now, of course, this is a special verb, so not all the conjugations are the same, but the present negative form of this is じゃありません, and that uses the same conjugation as mass verbs for the present negative, which is ません. Verbs are conjugated for the present positive, the present negative, the past positive, and the past negative. So present positive is mas, present negative is masen, past positive is mashita, past negative is masen deshita. So as an example, we're going to use a very simple verb that you probably will actually use a lot, which is tabemasu, which is to eat. So the present positive of tabemasu is tabemasu, the present negative is tabemasen, the past positive is tabemashita, and the past negative is tabemasen deshita. Now luckily when you're using the mas form, there's not really any special or tricky verbs. All the verbs in the mas form pretty much work around mas, masen, mashita, masen deshita. It's just memorizing this conjugation and making sure that you use it in situations that are appropriate. And so you really need to think about when you're using a verb in the present compared to when you're using a verb in the past. 今日僕は食べます compared to 今日僕は食べました. The first one, 今日僕は食べます, is today I will eat, compared to 今日僕は食べました, today I ate. Now, they're both happening today, but one already happened today and one will happen today. And I know when I say today I will eat, you're thinking, well, that's not necessarily present positive because it's not happening at this exact moment. For present positive and present negative, it's including the present and the future. So like from this point on. And when you're talking about the past, it's anything before this point. So keep that in mind when you're forming sentences. Let's go over a few more verbs and just go through the conjugations really quick so that you'll be able to get the hang of it. Other verbs that are used pretty frequently are 飲みます, which is to drink. 飲みます, 飲みません, 飲みました, 飲みませんでした. 聞きます is to hear. 聞きます, 聞きません, 聞きました, 聞きませんでした. 書きます is to write. 書きます, 書きません, 書きました, 書きませんでした. So I know this isn't necessarily an interactive video, or at least I'm not saying it is, but I am going to give you a really quick quiz right now because I think that's the best way for you to study the conjugations and when to actually use them. So if I wanted to say, I drank yesterday, how would I say that? I drank yesterday would be 昨日飲みました。You can also say 昨日私は飲みました。But as I was saying in past videos as well, we tend to cut things out depending on the context and if you're able to understand. If I wanted to say tomorrow, I will write. How would I say that?That would be 明日私は書きます。If I wanted to ask my friend, what did you hear? That would be 何を聞きましたか?何を聞きましたか? If I want to say, I didn't eat yesterday, how would I say that?That would be 昨日食べませんでした。昨日食べませんでした。Now hopefully you got all those correct, but if you didn't, make sure to check out the past lessons. Besides the verbs themselves, a lot of the things that I pulled were from the previous lesson as well as lessons before. So make sure to review those if you're having a bit of trouble. That's where we're gonna stop here. I know it's a lot of information, right?So, also because you don't know a whole lot of verbs, it's a little hard to get the hang of it. We went through 食べます、飲みます、聞きます、and 書きます。So those are the four we went through today. In future videos, I'm going to be adding more to the list as well. We're more or less going through verbs that you use a lot in daily conversation. I'm going to focus on those a little more than verbs that you need to know for the JLPT standardized test or anything like that, because we're working more on communication rather than a standard test or anything like that. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. Don't be shy about anything. Feel free to practice your Japanese in the comments as well. I will forSure, respond and you know we can have a conversation or anything like that. Make sure to like this video if it helped you in any single way or you just like my content and want to be nice, that would be great as well. And subscribe to get notifications about when I post new videos. Right now I'm posting new Japanese lessons every single day during the month of April, so we still got a while to go. And that'll be it for this lesson. I'll see you in the next one. Mata ne!